Hey guys, welcome back. This is the 26th lecture of our bootcamp series. In the last lecture, we have created our first controller and added an action into it. So you can see that we have created a welcome controller and added an index action into this. Okay. Now in this video, we will map this controller action to a route and then render the view template for this action. Okay. So first we need to create a folder into the app view directory with the same name as your controller. Okay. For example, we have created our controller and name it as welcome. So we will create a directory with name welcome into the app views. So first create the directory with name welcome. Okay. Now the directory can have various files and usually the name of the files based upon the action name into the controller. Now since we have created an index action into the welcome controller, so we need to create a index.html.erv file into app views welcome. So just create a new file into the welcome that and name it as index.html.erv. Now, we need to create a route for rendering this template on the browser. Okay, so first add some text on the browser, or let's keep it blank now and go to the routes file. Okay, you can find the routes.rb file into the config, and this routing file is to keep all the routes through which you can navigate inside your applications and you can submit requests and all that. Okay, so let's create a route for it. Get welcome / index. Okay, this is the format of creating route. Okay, there are more complex format for creating routes that we will see into upcoming lectures when we see resource and routing in more detail, but just for now, for simplicity, just keep it this is the format, and the left hand side of the slash symbol is the controller name and the right hand side is the action name into that controller. Okay, now to open this page into the browser, you just need to go to your browser and must have your Rails server running. Now let's come here and add welcome index. Okay, so you can see that an empty page is rendering on the browser. Why? Because we haven't write anything inside the index.html.erv. Let's write some code. Let's write welcome to the Rails. Now you can see that something is displayed on the browser. Okay, and if you want to check from terminal, then you can also see that the request is welcome / index and it is processing by the welcome controller's index action. Okay, now it's rendering inside the application layout and then it is rendering the welcome / index.html. Okay, that means when you go to this page, your Rails will be looking for the welcome directory inside the views directory, and into the welcome directory it will looking for the index.html.erv template. Okay, so that's what we have done so far, that we have created an action and we just map that action to a route and then rendered the template on the browser. Now what we need to do, that we need to set up this as root page, because this is not a root page so far. This is our root page, and now when we visit the root page, we will still see the default Rails welcome page. So to make it root path of our application, just open the routes.rb, and yeah, before mentioning it as root path, just come to the terminal and you can see that when I visit the root path, you can see the started get slash. So slash is for denoting the root path, and when it is processing by welcome controller index section of the Rails. So this is coming from the Rails middleware, and this is not implemented inside our Rails project. Okay, so we need to mention our root path now. So to mention the root path, you just need to make it like root welcome hash index. Okay, now this page becomes your root path. Okay, and now you can remove this line. Okay, just remember this format, that the slash has been replaced by the hash symbol here. So your root path will be welcome hash index. And one more thing, that this hash is only used for the root path or for mentioning the root path. So now let's come to the browser and refresh the page again, and you will see that root path, and the template is rendered at the root path of the application. And here you can also see that now the root path is served by the index section of the welcome controller. Okay, so that is the main thing, and this is the questions time now. Okay, so the few questions from this video, that how to create a custom route in Rails, how to create a root path in Rails, and how you create and store template for a controller action. So just watch the complete video and you will find all the answers for these questions, and then in the next lecture we will go into more deep of the tutorial. Okay, so thanks for watching the video. Till then, tata, goodbye, take care, stay safe, and let's meet into the next lecture.